Tavo with the exercise of the week. Today, I will be doing the bench press.
Bench presses are a slow range of motion. Take your time and always have good form.
Always have your hands equally spread apart. This is how you do a bench press.
This is not how you do a bench press. The bar becomes very wobbly and it'll be hard. This is not how you do a bench press. You always need to have your feet planted on the floor so you can make yourself more steady. The bench press works out your pectorals, shoulder muscles, and your anterior deltoid. This exercise helps you work your upper body strength.
We have lunch here. And the person who deserves this title works really hard and has passion for his job. He works his best to get the food, the nutritious, healthy food that us kids need. He has a good relationship to everyone around him.
Welcome to the Mustang Cafe. How can I help you?
This is why we believe Mr. Toon is our lunch hero.
Thank you, Mr. Toon!
Good morning, Meadowbrook. This is Perla with a few words of wisdom. Have you ever made the choice not to prepare for an exam, and then when it was time to take the test, you suddenly wished you'd made a wiser choice? It's an interesting thing about choices. They all come with a consequence, good or bad. American evangelist Dr. Billy Graham once said, "We make our own choices, and we pay the price for those choices." This week, be aware of the dozens of choices you make every day, and think about the consequences of those choices. Notice how good behavior brings you good results and bad behavior brings you bad results. Take a look at how good study habits bring better grades while poor study habits can bring poor grades. Remember, all our choices come with a consequence. It's a simple formula with predictable results. With something to think about, this is Perla. Make it a great day or not, the choice is yours.
What's up, Mustangs? This is your ASB president, Ethan. As we settle into the routine of this new year, I'd like to share some inspiring words from Walt Disney. All our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. We've all had dreams before, both asleep and awake. What separates dreams from reality is courage. It takes courage to step out of your comfort zone, to face challenges head on, and to believe in ourselves even when the path ahead seems uncertain. Now, courage doesn't mean the absence of fear. It's just the opposite. Courage is to choose to proceed in the face of fear. It's the commitment to do the right thing, no matter how difficult it is. Remember, every success story began with someone who dared a dream and then had the courage to pursue it. So as we begin this new year together, the solution is clear. Courage is the key to your dreams. Mustangs, let's embrace the spirit of courage together. Let's support each other, lift one another up, and create an ecosystem here at Meadowbrook where courage thrives and dreams come true. Let's make 2024 a momentous year to remember.
But before I go, this is a reminder to stop by the Mustang Market and show some school spirit. Bye, Meadowbrook.
Good morning, Meadowbrook. This is Caden with the best of the week. What was the best of your week?
Winning my soccer game.
I'd say the best of the week was coming back to school and hearing about everybody's awesome vacations.
The best part of our week is playing soccer.
What was the best part of your week?
Probably getting a new Nintendo Switch.
The best part of my week was playing with my dog.
The best part of my week was sleeping over at my friend's house and going e-biking.
That was Caden with the best of the week. Bye, Meadowbrook.
This is SheHub with the word. Hey, wrong way. We're going that way. With the word.
The definition of major is very large or important.
Hello. This car needs major repairs.
The second word is method. The definition of method is a planned way of doing something.
No, this is never gonna work. We need to try a new method. That's a good idea.
This is She-Hop with the word up. We're gonna switch places, all right?
Okay.
This is Sophia with the word up. Bye, Meadowbrook.
Well, Rosalind was right. This book is really old. It's gone through all the seasons, but the good deeds aren't old. So let's race right here.
If you got picked this week, please go to the front office to claim your prize. And if you didn't get picked this week, your cards will go into the Pizza with Friends box that will be pulled at the end of this trimester.
Good morning, Meadowbrook. We'd like to congratulate the top reading patrons in the library from 6th to 8th grade. The first prize is for 6th grade, and it goes to Kenneth Jennings. Our 7th grade prize goes to Samantha Reich, and our 8th grade prize goes to Grady Quinn. We are thrilled to recognize your dedication to reading and learning. As a token of our appreciation, you've won a Barnes & Noble's certificate thanks to our lovely Heather Becker. Please come to the library whenever you get a chance. Your commitment is commendable, and we hope you continue to explore the wonderful books. Thank you for being an avid reader and supporter for our library.
Hello, and welcome to today's episode of Good Morning Meadowbrook. We will be interviewing your ASB about an exciting upcoming event, the Winter Semi-Formal, The Night Under the Stars. Welcome, Claire.
Thank you for having me, Jalen.
So tell us a bit about Night Under the Stars.
Yeah, well, to start, it's our winter semi-formal dance event. It will be on February 2nd. We will have music, food, games, prizes, photo station, and a special seated dinner.
Nice. That sounds pretty cool. I bet the tickets are expensive, though.
That's the best part. Tickets are only $5. I'm actually pretty happy about that.
Amazing. Hey, let's talk about the semi-formal thing. What does that mean?
Yeah, so semi-formal usually means dressing up, which is encouraged, but not required. So, in fact, we really respect our students' sense of style. You could be more formal, or do your own thing. Either way, all we care about is you guys coming and having a great time.
That's cool. Thanks for information. Make sure to come on February 2nd to our semi-winter formal dance.
The winter dance is on February 2nd. Can't wait to see you there.
Thank you for watching the Meadowbrook News. This is a reminder that the Mindful Minute will start after the pledge. Please stand, place your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Go for it.